Test, test, test. 1, 2, 3. Let's see. Let's get the lights in order here. Hello, Cedric. Hello, MJ. It's good to see you too. Let's see. Go and that goes to 30 and this can go just a smidge. There we go. So glad to hear things seem to be working. I was a bit late, but also I had the wherewithal to actually do, repurpose on, oops. There we go. Okay. Let's see. Just do this. There we go. I was about to say I'm late, but I also had the other wherewithal to do all of the it's checklist tasks. So streamer song list is already up. So is the other streamer song list tab. I reset my network adapter, did all of the checks for the sound, which, really. Pre-flight checklists exist for a reason. If I was as diligent about it as I know pilots tend to be, I would probably have fewer technical issues. But luckily, I'm not responsible for taking a multi-million dollar aluminum tube through the sky with hundreds of lives in my hands. There we go. Hello, hello. I'm glad to see that you two were chatting before I even got here. Oh, missed an item on the checklist. Keeping yourselves entertained, I'm glad to hear. Let's see. Go. All right. Whew. Let me throw the I'm live announcement up real quick, and then we shall get going. Let's see. There it is. Feels weird trying to type over my violin. It's like the hand posture's all weird. I can't find the keys. I hit plus instead of hitting underscore. Just, ugh, ugh. All right. I think everything is pretty much good to go. Balbs is unfortunately. Yes, Balbs? Do you see something out there? You know, summer approaches. I have half a mind to actually get a proper light blocking curtain instead of this thing. This is wonderful in daily use because, you know, it can just let some of the light in, but also pretty much block any of the actual, like anybody seeing through it very much. But the poor camera is trying to deal with the blazing sunlight while also trying to deal with the internal lighting, which is, poor thing. All right. Let's warm up for just a second and then actually get going with the stream. This first one is a request from Cedric. This is Town of an Ocean View from Kiki's Delivery Service. I forgot to do something with the camera that makes it so that it doesn't sit there and try to autofocus the whole time. Otherwise, it picks up foreground objects, or it picks up my bow arm, or and then goes back to the background, or it's just ugh. Thank you. go. Yeah, it's a gorgeous piece. Also, it's... it really captures the, like the feeling of the town. Kind of that gentle... I mean, it plays when she's flying there, right? So just, you know, not too much worry. Just a nice, gentle flight into town. Thank you for the request, Cedric. Oh my. Who's in an audience? Who's in audience? In audience? That's grammatically correct, right? I wonder what they like. More of the classical stuff, the Celtic stuff, or... oh! Your parents, too. Let's see. Do you want to go hard on the games, or... or perhaps, they would know Lord of the Rings and Pirates of the Caribbean more? I don't know how much of, your love of games they share. That's sent to... what's this, Beauty and the Beast? I can definitely play that. Let's see, let's see. Let's throw that in queue. Actually, let's play When You Wish Upon a Star as well. Probably play before that. After it? Maybe after it. Alright. This is Beauty and the Beast from Beauty and the Beast. Is Beauty and the Beast from Disney's Beauty and the Beast. Let's see, let's see. There we go. Yes, miss. Already. Thank you, thank you. Let's see. Up next, before I play Underwater Waltz, I'm going to play When You Wish Upon a Star. From Disney's Pinocchio, I think. Wait, do I have When You Wish Upon a Star on the list? I'm not quite sure. Was When You Wish Upon a Star from Disney's Pinocchio. And thank you for the request for Beauty and the Beast, MJ's mom. Thank you, thank you. Next we have Underwater Waltz. And then after that, we have the Pirates of the Caribbean medley. First, Underwater Waltz. This is from Nintendo's Super Smash Bros. Not Super Smash Brothers. God. Super Mario Bros. Thank you. was the Underwater Waltz by Kondo Koji. Thank you. Oh, we have a few requests coming in. My apologies for the cat sounds in the background. We have Pirates, and then Comet Observatory, and then Kirby's Gourmet Race. All right, let's see. Oh, I forgot to do a thing. There we go. I did the thing. So this is a medley of music from Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl. Music from Pirates of the Caribbean by Hans Zimmer. Let me go take care of a cat thing real quick. Oh, hello. Oh, let's see. I guess welcome to the stream officially, or welcome to the chat portion of it anyway. So I think stream is enjoyable even without chat, but chat makes it a lot better. And thank you for the that request, Karma. There's one more from you. It's Rosalina's Comet Observatory. Chat is fun. By the way, I'm wondering, how many of you have actually played Super Mario Galaxy? And for those that haven't, but knew this piece before you heard me play it, where did you hear it first? was Rosalina's Comet Observatory. Thank you. And thank you for the requests, Karma. That's one of those pieces that never get tired of playing. I'm a little afraid to overplay it, but also. My son raising his hand from playing Galaxies, me too. Hello, hello, Verity. It's good to see you again. Right, Super Mario Galaxy. So, what are your favorite galaxies? So for me, I remember it was like one of the water worlds, but it was a loop. I don't know if it's like Loop Pool Galaxy or something like that, but I think the first part of it, I think, is like a manta ray race, but the controls are really janky on the Wii. But also the music is really nice, and the way they depicted water in galaxies is just gorgeous, especially considering the era it was made in. You know, it's like Wii games are technically retro now and have been for at least 5 or more years. Yeah, it was a pain. How's your evening going, by the way, Verity? Oh, the water rendering was cool from what I've seen. Yeah, it really was. Okay. Next piece is the Gourmet Race from Kirby Superstar, written by Ishikawa Jun. Evening's going well. That's good. Hopefully I can make it even better. Kirby's Gourmet Race. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for the request for that, Maddie. Let's see. Clapping sounds, yay! Oh. one of the pieces that I'm currently learning is from another Kirby song. Because I only have two pieces from the whole series, I think, compared to other Nintendo titles that I know. That's relatively low. I think like Mario, I probably have 6 or more pieces, maybe 7 or 8. Says Zelda, of course I have, you know, probably nearly 10. Even Pokemon has 5 or 6, so... Pardon? Let's see, what shall we play that actually drained the cue list? Maybe some Chrono Trigger. This is the opening theme, and the main theme from Squaresoft's Chrono Trigger, circa 80-something? 90-something? I don't remember. Yeah, Big Banger kind of coming up. Oop, sorry. The main theme to Chrono Trigger, written by Mitsuda something. Let's see. Can I research it under Mitsuda? Yeah, Mitsuda Yasunori and Nakamura Mitsunobu. Thank you. Like MJ said, that one's a big banger. That is definitely one of my, one of the ones that really has the most drive in my repertoire. Like a lot of it tends to be more calm pieces, a little more serene stuff. But every once in a while, there's something like that one. Or just has all of the drive. Let's see. Speaking of serene and calm, the next one by request is concerning hobbits. This is, of course, from Peter Jackson's Lord of the Rings, written by Howard Shore. Concerning hobbits. Yes, miss. Oh. You know, if you demand attention and then go out of reach, I can't give you pets. So, for those that don't know, I have three kitties, one of which is very, very demanding during stream. She's generally not too, demanding, just comes over and says, hey, pet me. But during the 2 to 3 hours of streams, just like every 30 minutes. Okay, off you go. I've got a stream. I've got to play. And no, you can't have my slippers. Okay. Let's see. Thank you for that request, Karma. Let's see, the next one is File Select from Super Mario 64. And I'll probably also put Inside the Castle Walls after this as well, since it's a little short. Anyway, this is File Select and Inside the Castle Walls from Super Mario 64. Thank you. was File Select and Inside the Castle Walls from Super Mario 64. Now this is it's a kitty. So I think the Luna you're thinking of, is it pony or kitty? So I don't remember what the kitty from Sailor Moon, its name is, who sort of resembles this, but the marking on the forehead is a little different. Ah, Sailor Moon Kitty, yeah. Very similar. I remember watching Sailor Moon when I was 3 or 4? Like, really, really small. And this was back in Japan, and I think during the original run, it was back-to-back with Slam Dunk, I think. And so I only ever got to watch one of those, so... yeah, Sailor Moon. Let's see. I think I missed... oh, the Filthy Hobbitses. In their holes, you know, their nice clean holes, stocked with food and drink. A few years older than that when we got it in the U.S. Yeah. Actually kind of curious how long the, how long it took them to, get it over here. Yeah, it's, like, I haven't really super paid attention to U.S. releases. It's like, even now I tend to just watch them in their original forms, whether it's manga or anime, and it gives me a lot more access, especially because, like, especially with manga, most of them just won't ever be translated, right? Unless fan translators translate it. And that's usually a slow process, and, you know, somebody has to like it enough for a group. Like a translator, you know, translator, editor, typesetter, one or two other roles, I think, to actually get something translated. I have no idea, but now I'm curious too. Fan translations take forever, yeah. Except for the really popular series where there's like three groups vying to get it out, like, you know, a day before it comes out in Japan sometimes. Which is a little much. Like, I realize there's competition, but not the sort of competition that I would want to be involved in. Doing quick translations is not fun. Beethoven Violin Romance number 1 in G major? Unfortunately, that's not in my repertoire, and for requests, I tend to only take soundtrack requests. I'm kind of curious. I wonder if IMSLP has it. SLP... Beethoven... Unfortunately, yeah, no worries. Welcome to the stream, though. I do have some classical repertoire, but it's another classical composer that starts with a B. And it's... well, I guess I have a couple other pieces, classical pieces besides, but I think most of it is Bach cello suites. Well, let's see. Romance in G major... wait a minute, that's... said Romance number 1. This is Romance number 40. Oh, Opus 40. Okay, good. Good. Doo-ba-doo. That's a complete score. Violin solo. I'm just looking it up because I'm curious to see how difficult it is. Sometimes I can, you know, sight read things. Other Times. It's a classical piece that I absolutely will not be able to play. Let us see. Let me get this in a different display format real quick. This will be 29.7. Quick translations aren't 100% accurate. Yeah, they absolutely are not. And of course, no disrespect to the... Oh, wait a minute. That's... Oh, that's why. Okay. Now where did I put the darn thing? IMSLP, there we go. Oh, that's a little big. Go and can I do this? Let's see. Work? No. Okay. I guess I'm just going to have to read it a page at a time. What is it? F major? By the way, this is just total sight reading and not going to be in tempo. I can already tell this is a classical piece that, given a month or two, I would be just fine playing, but yeah, digital page turner. There are Bluetooth pedals that you can use because tablets are really nice for sheet music, and of course, you know, when it's just foot pedals, you can just, you know, be in a concert and not have to stop or really worry too much, but yeah, it's something I want. It's something a duet partner and I have talked about getting at some point, but it's also a $50-ish investment. Like, it's Bluetooth, so yeah, really. So many times when even with paper sheet music, you know, one is fine, two is fine, three is pushing it, four is like, okay, let's just get two stands together. But there are definitely pieces where you need all four pages, which sucks, but it helps. Let's not get into things. Not while I'm streaming, anyway. All right. Let's see how well I can see sight read classical sheet music. Let's see. Thank you. don't think I've done a proper sight reading of classical music in quite a long while. That felt, well, nostalgic for one. Sorry I don't have it to just play off the bat. Let's see. Playing outside, the wind blows the pages everywhere. Oh gods, yes. Oh gods. For the longest while, I think maybe even now, you know those like simple wooden clothespins? I would always have four of those in my case. Because you need at least two for you, sometimes two more for you, and maybe two more for somebody else. It's like standard equipment if you're playing outside with sheet music. Oh, hi, Al. 10:12. Oh, I'm all the way over in Oregon. Actually, right now it's approaching the twilight hours. It looks brighter than it is. This camera is not very good at dealing with sunlight. Glad to see you again. Came out yesterday after seeing a Fibonacci music video. Thank you so much. Why is your sight reading better than my playing after learning this piece for 2 weeks? So, however you feel towards me, that's how I tend to feel towards people that are in orchestras. They tend to be able to often somewhere near sight read, like whole symphonies. And it's just a matter of practicing sight reading, practicing sight reading, practicing sight reading. And of course it helps to have base skill, but also like, you know, proper intonation and shifting and all of these skills that we use to play are sort of useless in sight reading unless you also have the sight reading skill set practiced, which sucks. But also, it's, yeah, so you actually have to practice sight reading itself. I'm not quite sure how old you are, what sort of training background you have. I know for me, prepping for orchestras and for university, my teacher was very much insistent on practicing sight reading as part of our lessons. You know, just whip out a piece of sheet music, slap it on my stand and go, all right, let's try to sight read this a couple of times, then you'll never see it again. And then a week or two later, another different piece of sheet music. It was horrible. It's a lovely concert. Oh, hello, welcome to the stream, Faith. Also, Alonia Newcomb and Max Lisbell. Welcome to the stream, all three of you. It's, sight reading is not usually what I do, especially classical music. I tend to play mostly soundtracks. I have classical background, but I mostly use those skills for playing, you know, Mario, Zelda, Final Fantasy, as well as, you know, Lord of the Rings, Pirates of the Caribbean, as well as anime. There's, what do I have for anime? I think my anime repertoire is the most constricted. Yeah, that's, I have a, oh, perfect. The Nightbot sent out a link for streamer song list. That's my whole repertoire. I think I have 84 pieces in there at the moment. Pardon me. And, oh, that's not right. Oh, that's why. Yeah, you can request as many as you'd like. It's pretty much something for everyone in here, including some Celtic and some classical. Let's see. Let's get back to the requests. I think I played file select. Sorry to keep your request waiting for so long, Verity. Next one is Bolero Fire. Favorite classical composer? Mahler. I think I've been invited to play Mahler symphonies now and again. I think there's a community Mahler playing in Portland. Maybe every year, maybe every other year. And it takes like double the usual symphony size. So just try to get everybody in the community to contribute. For me, classical composer-wise, it's probably Bach, hands down. Part of it is the cello suites. Another part of it is that I had 5 years after I graduated high school where I really didn't play too much. It was effectively a hiatus. And I fell basically head over heels for Bach's Partita number 2. And specifically the performance by Hilary Hahn. And her performances of Bach repertoire are just absolutely gorgeous. But something about the Partita number 2, the first movement, I had to play it, and then I picked my violin back up, and I've not looked back since. I've played the Partita number 2 here and there on stream, but right now it's been so long since I've actually had it properly. Oh, why do I have reverb on? Had it properly in my repertoire, so I actually have to bring the sheet music out, and like I stop once or twice. It's a little embarrassing, especially because there are some very good musicians in the stream. In fact, a few of my regulars are musicians that I would definitely listen to, and I both have listened to their recordings. Let's see. Fox pieces are really fun to play. Yeah, especially the, for me, the partitas are cool, violinist, blah, 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 but like, the Bach cello suites are just so good. I know way more of them than I do the violin pieces. If you chant his name, you sound like a chicken. Okay. Ow. Okay. I'm going to start playing music before my cheeks explode. This is music from Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, including Bolero of Fire. Hi, Vicky. Thank you. That was music from Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, including A Blaro of Fire, Menuet of Forest, which is, by the way, a minuet, I just realized, MJ, and then Song of Storms, which we talked about being a minuet yesterday, and then Song of Time, and then Zelda's Lullaby. Thank you, thank you. It's a pleasure, Verity. Thank you for requesting it. Welcome to the stream, Amos. Glad you're enjoying it. So unfortunately, I only know English and Japanese, so I need translators. There we go. Let's see. Paganini. I don't know any Paganini, unfortunately. So my classical repertoire is relatively, relatively small. And for requests, I tend to only take, soundtrack requests. How's Cedric doing a fine job? Yeah. That was cool. Toccata and Fugue. I wish there was a good solo version for it. Actually, there might be. Let me put a search tab over here real quick. Toccata and Fugue in... Is it D minor or G minor? Oh, thank you, Max. Glad you're enjoying it. It's kind of hard on violin, but it sounds good. Yeah, it's Google Translate. Oh, no. Oh, no. I hope it works. I hope Google Translate works better for your language in English compared to Japanese and English, where it just doesn't work at all. D minor, let's see. Let's see, MSLP probably has something. There it is. Okay. And I'll leave that in the... Oh, Peru! Cedric agrees with me. Google Translate? No! Okay. Let's get through the requests. So the first one is the legendary hero from Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. And then we have Liebeslied, which is a classical piece written by Fritz Kreisler. And then we have Wind Scene from Chrono Trigger. Right, so first, here's the legendary hero, the opening scroll from the Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. Thank you. That was The Legendary Hero from Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, written by Kondo Koji, Minegishi Toru, Nagata Kenta, and Wakai Hajime. Wind Waker had four composers, which is a lot. I think most that I see, one or two, usually one. And thank you. And thank you, welcome to the stream, Wanderer. Let's see. The Legendary Hero is the intro sequence to The Wind Waker. And so part of it is the bum bum ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, bum bum theme. And then it goes into that main Zelda theme and then darkens and comes back to its own theme. Any song from Hollow Knight? Oof! That's so, I only got to play Hollow Knight about 4 months ago. So I'm still working on getting some pieces from it. Although, what's her name? The yelly one with the needle and the red clothes. Her theme? I've definitely contemplated making writing out a duet version of it, because it's just so good. Dark Souls 3, I'm actually not quite sure. I haven't played any of the Dark Souls games. I got into FromSoft Games in Elden Ring. Oh, hello, Gooey. Hornet, that's the name. God's, her theme is so bloody good. A lot of the Hollow Knight themes, I think, work better on either guitar, piano, or harp. Just because of their, like, sparse, melancholy nature. But Hornet's theme works so well as a duet. Do I know any other themes that sound medieval? That's a good question. I guess some more of the Zelda stuff might. Sad Belkiat. Welcome to the stream. Mantis Lord. I'm currently stuck on Mantis. Oh, wait, no, I'm not currently stuck on Mantis Lord. Maybe? Anyway. Oh, yep, I'm stuck on Mantis Lord. Wait, is Mantis Lord the three? Or the exiled one? Let's see. There are some Zelda pieces that sound sort of medieval. I could also do Shepherd's Flute, come to think of it. Shepherd's Flute might be the best option if I can find Lineage 2 here. There we go. Put that in queue. For learning Japanese, whatever works and allows you to consistently do it is the best. Okay. Next piece is a classical piece called Liebeslied, written by Fritz Kreisler. It's a romantic era piece. Without realizing it, I ended up playing like the most important part of my classical training ended up involving romantic era pieces really heavily. And so that's sort of the sensibilities that I also tend to bring to soundtrack pieces, which is something that I realized, you know, a decade after the fact. It says, leave a sleet. And before I play, here's a water reminder. Like Zelda? If you have a Switch, go for Breath of the Wilds. If you have something else, Wind Waker is really fun. Link is really expressive. I think those would be my recommendations. Anyway, here is Liebeslied. Oh, before I forget, if you like the music, click the like button. If you'd like to find your way back here, click the subscribe button. I think I have donation links in the stream description if you'd like to support me that way. Was Leavis Lead, Love Sorrow by Fitzgraysler. Thank you. That's one of those non-Bach classical pieces that I have in my repertoire right now. So I think that and Meditation from Thais, I just practiced too much to forget. Majora's Mask is a great game, but sadder than Ocarina, yeah. It's a surprising It's a surprising tone for a Zelda game, I think. It has some of the melancholy of Breath of the Wild, but Breath of the Wild doesn't feel... There's some, like, futility with Majora's Mask, because, like, no matter who you save, you rewind time every time, right? And so it's, Majora's Mask gives me anxiety. Yeah. Definitely agree, MJ. Definitely agree. Spooky and anxiety-inducing. Yeah. Unlike Chrono Trigger. Here's the wind scene from Chrono Trigger. Oh, and thank you for the request for Leavis lead, MJ. Do I know any pieces from Persona? No, I don't, unfortunately. That Kirby theme? It is Green Greens. Or there's always the victory dance. Those are the Kirby pieces I know. Working on adding another, but it's not quite complete just yet. Also, Almas, here's a link to my whole repertoire. You can request stuff from there if you'd like. 3 at a time, I think. Pardon. And it all comes to my interface, and so I can keep track of all the requests, check them when they're done. Really should work on integrating the request list with the stream a little more, because there's a way where I can make the I think the next one or next 3 pieces that are on the list show up visually on stream. I think there are also some commands that I could put in stream to, where you can control the requests via text instead of having to use the web interface. But yeah, that's my whole repertoire. Anything that's not on there, I might be able to find for sheet music and sight read it. But things not on that list, I don't have in memory. Be some solid options in the Persona universe. I'm open to recommendations, since I haven't played any of the Shin Megami Tensei or Persona games. Oh, Pirates of the Caribbean. Okay. Oh, and we have Cyrus the Scholar on here too. This is looking good. Okay, so this one is from Wind Scene. This is from Chrono Trigger. Let's see. There we go. That's the thing I need to click. Thank you. That was wind scene. AD 600 AD, I think. It really is a good piece. What did I miss? Persona 4 and 5 are amazing games. Did I play Undertale? I haven't. I've watched my friend play it, and I have played, I think I have a duet version of Megalovania. But I haven't tried playing any pieces solo from Undertale. That was so relaxing. It's good to hear. It's very similar in game. Wait a minute. What? Battle against a true hero. Undertale. Oh, wait a minute. Let's see if we can find. That sucks. It looks like there's the ostinato that plays throughout the whole thing. A second person to keep that maintained while the melody's playing. That's why I also can't play Megalovania solo, is because you need that ostinato in the background, otherwise it just kind of, it's just meh. Another one from Undertale's Fallen Down. Let me How long have I been playing? 20, almost 29 years? It's been a while, yeah. Oh, you learned Fallen Down as your first piano piece. Ooh. Another one from, okay, I didn't miss anything. Good, good. Let me put that in a tab for now. Once I get through some more requests, I'll go back to it and we'll see how it sounds. All right, I forgot who's wanting another piece that sounded medieval. Maybe it was You Wanderer. But this is Shepherd's Flute, which is from a MMO called Lineage 2. Thank you. was Shepherd's Flute, written by Bill Brown. Next one, request from Cedric, is Cyrus the Scholar from Octopath Traveler. Cyrus the Scholar. It was written by Nishiki Yasunori for Square Enix's Octopath Traveler. Let's see, what did I miss? What did I miss? Let's see, that's Nightbot. There it is. Almas, you asked if I take requests other than video game soundtracks. So I do video games, movies, and anime. In terms of requests, I'm more likely to fulfill like sight reading requests for or learning requests for games and anime compared to movies. Unless it's either Disney movies or even more likely, Studio Ghibli. Oh, you did the other reprise first? Learned that instead of the original? Sorry, Bluebird. Let's see. Naruto Bluebird. Bluebird sounds really familiar, but I don't. It was an opening. That's why. Oh, interesting. Okay, let me also shove it over here. Let me play Pirates of the Caribbean real quick. And then we'll do the, try the sight reading ones real quick. My Neighbor Totoro? Yeah. Which one would you like? Which Sampo, which is the ending, or My Neighbor Totoro from My Neighbor Totoro? Okay, let's do Pirates first, and then we'll do sight reading. Oh, thank you, Vicky. Music from Pirates of the Caribbean, Curse of the Black Pearl by Hans Zimmer. Let me pull my mute off real quick because it's rattling around. Just put that there. Thank you, thank you. What are y'all's native languages? My first is Japanese, and then English is actually my second, although I learned both of them as more native tongues. Instead of having like one that's your native and one that like you learn from books. I was lucky enough that they're effectively both my mother tongues now. Latin Vatican. Okay, well, I think I found the problem. Yeah, that's the reverb module died on me. Let's see. So I'm running a VST 2. Some odd plugin for my reverb, right? And it is one of the points where I'm having issues a good bit. Test. That's with reverb. Let me. Test. I'm sorry. That was, yeah, I know that buzz. Yeah, that, So that buzz is, something that I have. So it's caused by the reverb, that I'm using. But often when I boot up OBS, I, will have to deal with that particular sound. And I have to sit there and, like, you know, I'll turn on my earphones so that I can monitor the sound. And I don't put my headphones on because what just happened to you all will happen, which sucks. I'm sorry. I think we're out of reverb for the day. Sorry. I used a different reverb plugin, and evidently it also causes that. Yeah. Sorry. So yeah, I guess no reverb for the rest of the stream. I don't know what it is. It's like, yeah. And like I said, when I start OBS a lot of the time, oh, all right. Are you going to sleep, Cedric? We can live without it? Yeah. My soul left my body, oh dear. Again, sorry about that. Night night, Cedric. Sweet dreams. See you again next week. Okay, so I guess we will carry on with no reverb. So this is a sight reading of Fallen Down from Undertale. Thank you. quite see the last bit. Okay. I couldn't see the last measure and a half. Oh, night, night, Almas. Sweet dreams. Hopefully I'll see you again. Just dawned here. It's 5 a.m. Oh, God's wonder. Oh, that puts you Western Europe? Western Europe is probably the only way you can get 6 hours from the west coast of North America to, yeah. If you're never practiced that, yeah, that's literally just sight reading. I literally pulled up a random link. Looked up, what do you call it? It's Fallen Down, Undertale Fallen Down sheet music in a search engine. Found this and just read it. Oh, the Vatican. Yep, the Vatican, of course. I forgot about that. McDonald's for breakfast, oh gods. Cup of java and some fresh baked pastries. Oh, that sounds good. I forgot to have dinner, so I'm hungry. Before I sight read Bluebird, and then get to the rest of the requests, I'm going to put some rosin back on my boat. And to whoever requested Fallen Down, if you haven't already and you liked it, subscribe button. Don't smash it, otherwise it'll stop working. Just, you know, plunk. Gently. I promise it'll have the same effect. Smush it with love. Give the subscribe button a nice big old hug. It has also dawned on me, a gentle tippity-tap, yep, that I don't have my usual, oh dear, this is actually my around the house scrunchie. Normally for streams, I tend to put on something a little more solid, but also something that doesn't come through on camera, because I tend to have the ribbon as the main visual piece back here. There we go. Alright, we can put this back on. Honestly, Fallen Down feels the reprise. It feels like I could probably just learn the piece from the piano sheet music. Yeah. Okay, Bluebird, which is going to be probably a good bit harder. So we will take our time with it. Also, the sheet music is itsy bitsy. Absolutely and utterly tiny. Let's see if we can... Okay, there we go. I'm going to have to pause now and again. But now the sheet music is actually readable. Piano to guitar gets really weird from time to time. Ooh, yeah, I can imagine. piano to violin is kind of the same way. It's like you have to pick what needs to be played out of the myriad notes that, you know, a pianist has to deal with. Violin is just like, oh, good end of the stream. Thank you, Vicky. Oh, right. Oh, gods. Well, thank you for coming. It's always good to have you. And I will see you. Wait a minute. I wonder if it's in the request. It is. Let me play you two Zunarkand on your way out. No, not a goodbye without two Zunarkand. To Zunarkand from Final Fantasy X, written, of course, by Uematsu Nobuo. Glad you like it, Wander. Good night, Vicky. Take care. Sweet dreams. And let me take a quick 5-minute break. I will be back as quick as I can, and then we can play out the rest of the requests and the sight reading for Bluebird. All right, I'll be right back. Hello, I'm back. Thank you, thank you. How's life doing? Interesting. Doing what I can to survive. And streaming is part of it. It's honestly the most consistent way I've been able to make sure that I have that I perform every week. And I still have stuff that gigs that I have coming up, but streaming feels like home for me, which is really nice. Maybe Grace with Kitties if we're lucky. Pretty good, all things. Currently lining up so stress levels are as low as reasonable. That's good to hear. Especially being a parent, that's... It's a rare treat to have, low is reasonable, or low as is reasonable, so not strictly low, per se. this is sort of the cat cam. About here is usually what a bit of right here back on the couch is where Aurora sometimes goes. She's actually sleeping a good full camera's width over that way. So without diving into it, it's been an interesting 4 years. Whew. Yeah, that's, yep. I feel that. Honestly, it's streams feel like rehab for the last 4 years. All right, so let's see. Got green greens. When you wish upon a star, my neighbor Totoro, and then, and then bluebird for sight reading first. So let's do. Let's actually do Bluebird first, and then we can do the other requests. And then, for anybody that's still here, if you want to add one or two more requests, maybe three, to the total pool, we can do those as the final 25-ish minutes of stream. Then we can end it around 2100 my time, top of the hour. Reading skills for the win, gods. I thought I had left all my sight reading training behind, you know, when I stopped having consistent lessons, and now here I am, you know, having sight reading practice almost forced onto me. All right, let's see. Joke's on me, yeah. All right. Let's do this. It's going to be slow. It's going to be plotty. I'll have to stop here and there, but we'll see how it goes. Intro section just for now. see. It's a little too hard for me to sight read, unfortunately. Getting the kiddo to bed and missed what this song is from. I recognize it though. So this is from Naruto Shippuden, Bluebird. I think it says the third opening. Unfortunately, I don't really know it. This is, at the very least, this version has some rather difficult portions that I, having trouble sight reading, which sucks, but oh well. I might actually see if I can find a what do you call it? A slightly simpler version or a or a version I've written out myself. At the very least, I need to listen to it. Nightbot sandwich. I'm in love with Nightbot. It's amazing anyway. Thank you so much. I nailed the Xenoblade sight reading last night, so there's that. Yeah. Still have it here. More Ardain. It's, once I take an actual, like a proper look at it, listen to the track, that's something that I could very easily just put in the repertoire list. As long as I have the sheet music, it's very playable. So, anyway, let me get through the requests list here. Do either of you have any piece you'd like to hear before the end of tonight? I forgot who requested My Neighbor Totoro. I don't know if they're still here. I think we're down to just a few people right now, so might just be us three, honestly. We had quite the peak, but also quite the drop-off because it's Sunday night. Winter by Vivaldi? No. I adore the piece, but I don't. I think the classical pieces I know are Bach Cello Suite No. 1, Movement 1, 3, and 5, Liebeslied, Meditation from Thais, I know, Bach Cello Suite 3, Movement 2? Movement 3? It's a beret. Violinists all know it. Sonata is more of a piano piece. Mario 64 staff rule? Yeah. Let's put that last. That way we can go out with something proper. Super Mario 64, staff roll. Last is the perfect spot for it. Let me take One You Wish Upon a Star out. The Green Greens, My Neighbor Totoro. Like to hear, that's so cool. Oh, would you like to hear the beret? I need to make sure I have sheet music for this because I don't know if there's a spot in the middle where my memory is going to blank out. Let's see. Cello Suite number 3 in C major. See if I can find a violin arrangement. Cello, flute, trumpet, violin. There we go. Let's see. Salamande, Corant, Sarabande, Bure. There it is. There it is. There it is. Wait a minute, is there more? Okay, good, 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 good. So we'll play the Bure, and then we'll go Green Greens, and then the one that was right before last, and then Super Mario 64 Staff. This is the Bach Cello Suite number 3 movement. 5, I think. So yeah. And come on, chair, you can do it. There we go. It's pretty much all violinists learning, like through the Suzuki method especially, will learn this. Relatively simple. So yeah. Enjoy. Thank you. Soon. Oh, I'm glad you liked it. It's kind of like Leave Us Lead and Meditation from Thais. I've practiced it enough that it's hard to forget, but also it's there are points where I'm always scared my memory is going to lapse. So that's what I like to have sheet music for nowadays. Thank you very much. So you can kind of see why I've taken to the Bach cello suites, even though I'm a violinist. It's, Let me... actually see if there's another Bach cello suite that I haven't played in ages, and I won't play the whole thing, but I'm kind of curious about it now. There's the one I'm used to. Not quite new. Definitely a piece that I've practiced quite a bit. This one does not play easily. This is number one. Why am I looking at number one? Oh, that's why. Okay, let's see. There we go. Number six, arrangements. Okay, let's see what we can do with this one. Here it is. We go. Let's see if we can get most of this on my screen here. Yeah, let's try this. All right, Wander. Thank you for staying with us so long. Thanks for coming. So I usually do these Friday, Saturday, Sundays, so it's hate work, but gotta pay my things. Yep, definitely did that for a long while. Take care. And here's a little bit of the gavotte from suite number six to play you out. Thank you. first part. And then, and that's without all the repeats. Second part is... goes back to one. There we go. There is. I practiced this quite a bit. So it sounds like there's a ton. The cello part is even worse. It's like swaps between three different clefs. I think it uses treble and bass and alto or tenor, one of those two. And this is the cellist reading all of those. So it's horrible. But yeah, no, it's... God, I practiced it for months. And then I actually used this to audition for a local amateur orchestra back in Japan. Which was part of my getting back into the habit of playing both solo and in orchestras. So I stayed with them until until I came back this way, and then I would get various pro jobs, pro orchestra jobs through the grapevine, because there were so many musicians there that everybody knows somebody that needs a musician. So yeah. That was a trip down memory lane. There were a lot of triple and quadruple stops where I dropped the bottom note because I don't remember them anymore. Especially the, let's see. Oh, this part doesn't really have triple stops. It was one of my favorite parts. Because hard. Yeah. That took a lot of practice. But this is what I mean when, most people are like, oh, violin, melody, instrument, gorgeous, right? And yes, gorgeous melodies, very similar to human voice, blah-de-da-de-da. And then me, I'm like, oh yeah, harmonies, counter melodies, sometimes, it's really nice to be able to have something other than just the melody so it doesn't sound so plain. And then Bach is just like, two, that's it, that's all, no, believe in yourself more, here's three, here's four, have fun. Like a grandparent telling you to keep eating. He's just like, no, you can play the organ part, you're fine. Oh yeah. I want to say it's like the third movement to the violin sonata number one. Violin sonata. I think this is it. Do it better. Yeah. God. I don't think he was a dick. Like, I think I mean, Beethoven has that rep, right? Like, especially as he was going deaf, he was like a little abusive. But Bach doesn't have that sort of reputation, but I imagine sort of this, you know, stern but very much stern but supportive, you know, believes in you, but will, you know, put you through a lot to make sure that you can believe in yourself. Let's see, which music do I use? Balbs, that is a paper bag. There is nothing in it for you. I will get you food afterwards. Balbs. The best kind of teacher, yeah. And so I was yelling at Balbs while pushing him with my feet. Oh god, that's big. Okay, can we do half? Half is this? Good gods. Balbs. So, this is a fugue, which Bach fugues are known for being the worst. And by the worst, I mean, not from a musical standpoint. If you look up Bach Violin Sonata Number 1 Fugue, one of my favorite pieces. And it one of the real violin unaccompanied movements that really hold a candle to a lot of the cello stuff that I like. But shenanigans for the shenanigans, yes. Here's the sheet music for it. Just scroll down to the fugue. It's the second movement. And just stare into the abyss. And in the meantime, enjoy me absolutely stumbling my way through it. God, I give up. Because that's as far as my sheet music goes for the time being. And then there's about 2.5 more pages of that. Yeah, that's, I think metalheads will be the first to tell you that metal is very, very much built on the back of classical music. And actually, it's, like, when I go out and play, you know, it's, sometimes I'll be playing when people are going into some kind of performance. Other times I'll be, like, near the smoking section and playing. Especially when I have a metal show that I'm playing for, I'll get a ton of classical requests. Like, it's the metalheads that really like classical music. But also, yeah, no, absolutely. Metal's just classical music with distortion amps and rock and hair. So yeah, it's in terms of like pieces that I want to play, I want to learn, but I don't know if I'll ever be able to play it in my life. This. Where Bach just kind of goes, here's the organ part. Have fun. But it's also bloody gorgeous. You know, it's... Yeah. Like, the way the harmonies change and... It's so good. It's literally one of my favorite movements of unaccompanied Bach, but it's kind of yikes. Oh dear, it's a little past 21 now. I have half a mind to just play the N64 staff roll and call it a night. My stomach is a gremlin. That's going on my classical playlist. It's a really good one. I'd honestly recommend just all six Bach cello suites because they're just all so damn good. 1 in 5 especially, I think. But also the prelude to 6 is also really good. Oh, is it just... It is just us two, isn't it now? That's surprising. Oh. Alright, I guess we'll do staff roll and then call it a stream. Yeah, that's... The peak of the stream was wee! And then Sunday night. Alright, here's staff roll with no reverb. That's another thing that I need to figure out. Gods. Chat was blowing up earlier. That was wild. Yeah. I couldn't keep up with chat. It was kind of scary, but also really nice. Like, you know, like, I would, like, be part of the conversation sometimes, but also chat just, you know, having a conversation as well. It feels good. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. It's for sheet music, ninsheetmusic.org. Definitely has this one. Probably in piano arrangement. Yeah, it's... Yeah. The nostalgia, definitely. The comfort nostalgia hits hard. It's like some nostalgia hurts, almost. It's, kind of that heart squeezy feeling. But yeah, it's Super Mario 64 staff roll is, like you said, a really comforting nostalgia. Which is, it's curious, isn't it? Oh dear, stomach says grumbly, grumbly. Staff roll's like a warm blanket of nostalgia. Yeah, it really is. It's like, it's not a complicated piece. It doesn't try to be, you know, emotional, like super expressive. It's just... It's got a real lightness to it, but also manages to evoke so much nostalgia and really so much emotion. It's a curious piece. By the way, thank you for the donation last week when I didn't even have stream. That was super surprising for me. But it helped a ton. Super glad I added that one. Yeah. So am I. Okay. You want more street song? Fair enough. Thank you for all your support. And I guess I'll see you here. I might do a Thursday night stream this week instead of a Friday night, because I think Friday night we're having to do some dress rehearsal for theater stuff that just can't be put on another day. But I also don't want to do a two stream weekend. I want to get back to the three stream weekends. So yeah. So very possibly Thursday, Saturday, Sunday this week. And also, I'll probably announce the theater stuff as well, because that's very much in-person Portland sort of stuff, so. Awesome. It's good to hear. I'll see you then, and I'm going to run and make sure I feed myself, and I promise I'll stretch. Ta-ta for now. Take care. Sweet dreams. Night-night. Soon enough, miss, I'll get to you. Take care, MJ. Night-night.